I call this chapter in my life, my year, my turn. If you didn't know this already, I like to call this a self-care channel, and I do a lot of videos about self-care and self-love, and I wanted to do a 2022 version of how to start your self-love journey and the steps that I am personally taking this year that are going to get me to where I want to be in life. So this is more of like a personal diary that I'm sharing with you guys about the things that I'm doing and the things that I'm implementing so that you guys can kind of get inspiration. And also, if you have not started your self-love journey, this might be a good way for you guys to get into that. If you are on the path of success similarly to me, then this video is definitely going to be for you. And success can mean so many different things. It could mean like financial success. It can mean success in relationships. It could be success in your growth journey. I wanted to do a video dedicated to the success of finding love in yourself and being able to conquer everything because you conquered the art of knowing yourself through and through and knowing what you love, what you like, what you don't like, and all of that. So this is pretty much like our selfish journey and our way to create a winning relationship with ourselves so that we can win in life. Loving ourselves is definitely number one. I know it's a struggle for a lot of us, and I definitely want to be the person who can teach you and guide you into creating a more loving way of speaking to yourself. Because always remind yourself, would I speak to a random person the way that I speak to myself? And if the answer is no, then you're probably going to need to start a self-love journey immediately. So let's get into that today. I'm so excited for us to chat. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram so you guys can always be updated on another video. And let's just get into how to start your self-love journey, how to love yourself, and all of the things that you need to do in 2022 to guide yourself in that direction. All right, let's get into it. Like always, like to remind you guys that I do read off of my laptop because I want to write everything down and not forget it. Okay, let's just address our physical appearance because I want to get that out of the way first. Now again, remember, this is my personal self-love journey, the things that I am doing in 2022. So if you do not have these issues in your life, then obviously skip certain steps, but these were issues that I needed to attend to, and a lot of them are coming from 2021, but I am carrying them into this year as well. So having self-love usually comes from within, and it should, but a lot of the times our confidence, our love for ourselves, our drive, all of that can really be propelled when we love the way we look and the way we feel about ourselves. So I have decided that this year, not only am I going to hyper focus on my physical appearance, but I am going to create a more healthy self-care routine that's going to make me feel happier and better, and definitely I want it to feel productive. So I always have taken care of myself, but sometimes I would fall off, especially when I was not attending to myself only. So for instance, when I got the puppies, I was not doing my hair and makeup anymore, and I was wearing sweats every day because taking care of two dogs when they were both puppies was kind of a nightmare, and I didn't really want to take care of myself. So this year, because I don't have any influences affecting that, we are going to be nourishing our bodies. I'm going to be working out 4 times a week. I'm eating clean. I want to do more body care rituals and making myself feel more beautiful, look into beauty routines that other people are doing, like brow elimination or anything that makes me feel beautiful. Of course, always getting like new wigs is something that's so important to me. Like, my hair is something that I care deeply about, and I just always want to make sure that I do the things for myself that will make me feel beautiful, because when I feel beautiful, I perform beautifully. I do feel that way. So physical appearance is definitely a good way to start when it comes to self-love, because if you've been kind of letting yourself go by the wayside, you haven't really been taking care of yourself, this is the time to do it. And it doesn't have to take a lot of money. You can do things at home. You can do DIY projects that will allow you to feel like more in tune with your feminine side, like body butters, and just doing like a more purposeful nighttime routine and taking care of your hair and having affordable perfumes that make you smell and feel beautiful. These are all things that you can do to create a better relationship with self-love and self-care. Okay, so the second thing is to tap into your inner confidence. A lot of people really struggle in life because they lack confidence. I don't know if you guys see like that viral TikTok, what is it, like video going around where people are saying like if you just show that you're confident, like people find you more attractive. It is so true. I find confident people attractive. There's been a few guys that I've met recently who aren't conventionally like the physical appearance that I would necessarily go for, but their confidence really made them sexy to me, and it really goes a long way. And that also goes for women as well. I mean, do I think that people do focus a little bit more on our beauty? Yes, but if you're a beautiful woman and you lack confidence and you're kind of like insecure and you walk weird and you're not really talking with purpose and emphasis and you just like lack like that pizzazz, I think people are going to notice that. So definitely tapping into your inner confidence, trying to address your insecurities. This is going to open up so many doors for you this year. You're going to see how people change when they're around you. They're going to be excited to see you. They're going to notice you more. You're gonna have more doors opening for you, opportunities, maybe even work-related things. Having confidence is literally key. Like, it is the best thing you could literally have. And I definitely just think that confidence also can go hand in hand with respect, and respecting yourself means that you view yourself as a higher value person. And we all want to tap into being high value people. We don't want people to think that they can walk all over us, disrespect us, or look at us as like low value. We want to always show, hey, like you can't fuck me over. I am somebody of value. I am somebody who is smart and independent and definitely all the things that you want to be. Literally write it down. It could be any single trait that you want. Write it down and show up as her. I'm telling you, you are going to see a major difference and a major shift in your life. And for me, I have always been super confident, but this year I am going to be on another level of confidence. Like, I want to be the sexiest, best version of me, and I don't really care if people find it offensive or they're not in love with it, because I know I am. Okay, so the third thing is to read more self-help and self-love books. I am the queen of going to the personal development section in Barnes & Noble. I love reading self-help books. They really make me feel amazing. I will link all of my favorite ones down below, because I don't want to get into books right now and like talk about each one and which one I like best. I really want you guys to understand the importance of being a well-read person. It is very sexy to be well-read. It is very hot to have that quality where you're not just beauty, you're beauty and your brains. And I find that this is something that attracts a lot of positive vibes, and you are more knowledgeable, which you can't beat knowledge. Like, I don't care if you didn't graduate college. I don't care if you didn't even graduate high school. Being well-read does not require for you to have a degree. This is something that you can do on your own in your own personal time, and you're gonna learn so much. Not only about personal development and yourself, but you're going to learn about other people. You're gonna learn big words. You're going to learn things that you can be able to share and guide other people through life with. And I think that that is just so beautiful and so important. So this is a huge part of a self-love journey, because you want to read things that are going to fill your brain with positive vibes and things that are going to motivate you and drive you and create that happiness that you need in order to focus on yourself, because you definitely need a little bit more motivation than just yourself to have this incredible self-love journey. You're going to have outside influences like reading and positive affirmations and YouTube videos that are strictly just for motivational speaking, and you're going to put that all together and you're going to create like a really great healthy bubble for yourself to stay in. I just think that being a smart, independent, sexy queen is like a triple threat, like a fucking triple threat, and it's honestly going to weed out all of the people who think that they can take advantage of you in life, because they literally can't. They know not only is she smart, but she's beautiful. I cannot screw this girl over, period. Okay, number four is to start dating yourself. Get to know yourself. Get to know your desires, your wants, your needs. Go on dates with yourself, do shadow work, heal yourself. These are all things that we need to do in order to move forward in life and become a better human being. Healing is huge. So in dating yourself and getting to know yourself, find the things that have triggered you over the years that you haven't addressed that you want to now. Also, it's really important to focus on yourself. A lot of people have avoided focusing on themselves. They really, really love putting themselves into other people and pouring out, you know, a lot of who they are through other people. And I understand that. If you're a natural empath, you're somebody who cares deeply about others, it may not come natural to you to care about yourself and to date yourself, but I want you to do the things that make you uncomfortable this year. So also doing shadow work. I can do an entire video about shadow work because I think it's so important. It's essentially, you know, going and tapping into the things that you've been avoiding, talking about with yourself, and just kind of figuring out a deeper, more meaningful way that you think and why you think the way you do and all of that. Get to know your desires, like I said before, sexual desires, emotional desires, what you want in a partner, what you want in a friend, what you want in a business partner. It could be anything. Definitely get to know these things about yourself. And when you start to date yourself, you're going to realize that you're going to fall in love with you. And when you fall in love with you, it's going to be really difficult for somebody to come and like penetrate that and ruin that. So it's really nice that you have yourself in this journey. And it's going to attract really great people in your life when and if you're ready to have people coming back into your life during any time where you say, you know what, I'm done with, you know, healing and creating like this meaningful life, and I'm ready to start introducing people into this newer version of myself. I think it's really beautiful. Okay, another huge part of, you know, your self-love journey is to declutter your life and make it livable. If you are a messy person, this could even just be messy-minded. It doesn't have to just be actual physical mess. You want to have a healthy space so that your mind can feel able to freely think. You don't want to have your space super cluttered. You don't want to always feel like your mind is racing, thinking about a million things. Like, reorganize your life, create a planner, have a schedule, have a calendar, map out different times for when you do different things. This is important. I also wanted to say to romanticize the moments in your life that you maybe have rushed or skipped over, like your shower routine, or, you know, when you put on your pajamas and your tea time and when you vacuum and clean your house. All of these things that seem a little bit like, ugh, I don't want to do it. I'm just not feeling it today. Romanticize this. Make it a beautiful moment. Make it sweet. Make it fun and enjoy these moments with yourself. You're going to start to realize that you're going to fall in love with doing things that you've never really cared for in the past. I know for me, something that I've been doing recently has been reading in the bathtub. I never did this before. I actually used to hate taking baths for years because it was a little bit too hot for me. So I've kind of mastered the art of figuring out the temperature, but now I like to read in the bath, or I'll even pin Pinterest things on my mood board, and I will even type up video ideas in the bath. This has been my way of slowing down my life and enjoying the little moments and romanticizing them and making them really amazing. So this is crucial in your self-love journey. And the last thing that I want to put out there is to address your demons. This is difficult because we do struggle with addressing things that hurt us and the traumas that we go through, whether it's, you know, something that happened in our childhood, something that happened recently, something that's currently happening in our life that we've been avoiding discussing and avoiding addressing. But this is the only way that you're gonna be able to grow and have a successful 2022, because you're going to finally work out the things that you have been avoiding and creating a healthier mindset for yourself moving forward. So whether that's going out to a therapist and speaking with somebody, or let's just say you're a procrastinator, like that's your issue at the moment, let's address that. Are you your own worst enemy? Are you your biggest critic? Let's address that. And these are all ways that you can discuss this with yourself so that you can have a better relationship moving forward with you. I know for me, my biggest issue has always been procrastination. I've talked about this in several videos. And the only way that I'm gonna be able to get any of the goals that I've been manifesting this year is if I address and get to the root of why I constantly procrastinate and why I struggle with prioritizing certain things that are important to me. And I, you know, want to conquer my goals and my dreams. And the only way that I can do that is if I work on the things that have been holding me back. So definitely go through that when you are doing your self-love journey. It's so important. I know this seems like very like, oh, like I know all of this, but sometimes you just need the reminder. As long as you allow yourself to grow every single day, you are going to be like that much closer to showing up for yourself. And I wanted to put this video out in 2022 because I think that a lot of people have really struggled with going through the motions. And I don't know if it has to do with the world we live in today where everything kind of moves a little bit fast, or maybe you're going through some personal mental health struggles which you need to address, but it could be anything. But I definitely want to see more people winning in 2022, and I want to see everybody being the best version of themselves, and the only way that you can do that is if you start working on you. So I hope this video helped. It was really, really amazing to film this today, and I am definitely going to be getting to work. I hope that you guys are as well, and let's just be the best versions of ourselves. Now let me know if you guys want me to do an entire video dedicated to a vision board. I know it's kind of past that time, but it's never too late to create one. And if you guys want to know how I have been personally conquering my goals already and what I like to do to create a vision board for this year, let me know down below and I will. And yeah guys, I hope that you guys really enjoyed this video. Like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.